Hi, this is DC Breaks on the DBS Institute YouTube channel, and in this video I'm going to be exploring a neural synthesis plugin called DDSP-VST, which you can use as a standalone VST synth or effects plugin within a DAW. And in this video I'm going to explore how you can use it as a synth, how you can use it to morph any input into a different output, and also some creative applications of using it as an effects plugin. So let's jump on in and take a look at DDSP-VST. So before we jump into live to look at how you can use DDSP in your DAW, I just wanted to take a moment to explain roughly how this works. You can see some examples on the Magenta TensorFlow website that explains how you can use it, but then there's also this information page that explains what DDSP is, and that is differentiable digital signal processing. In a nutshell, when you're trying to create a realistic sound using synthesis, there's lots and lots of different parameters that you need to control in a very complex way to recreate a realistic sound. So if you're trying to synthesize a clarinet, for example, there's lots of different characteristics that go into that sound to make it sound realistic. And that's why a lot of synthetic sounds don't really sound real. So in this situation, they're going to take a user input, pass it through a neural network that's been trained on data of the instrument in question, run that through some DSPs, and then you get a signal that should sound a lot more realistic. So that's it in a nutshell. There's some examples that you can hear on the website to give you an idea of how this works. So for example, you can hear a voice that's then turned into a violin using this process.
Somewhere over the rainbow.
So you can hear how the instrument is picking up on the nuance of the specific signal that it's being passed to recreate that with the sonic characteristics, if you like, of the instrument in question. And there's a bit more detail if you really want to get into how the signal flow works in order to actually achieve that. But let's jump into live now and see how we can use this as a creative tool. So I've got a clip of a guitar here. Let's hear how this sounds. And I'm going to now run it through the DDSP effect. DDSP comes as an effect and also a synth. We're going to start by looking at the effects unit. And within this, we now have the option to choose any number of these different instruments to morph our input into. You'll see also that you can train a new model here, but that functionality is currently actually not working, so we're not going to cover that in this video. So let's have a go at morphing then into a clarinet and hearing what kind of results we get. So those purple dots that you can see coming in, that's the input signal, and it's tracking it over pitch and volume. And so it's picking up a lot of that nuance, and then through the using the neural network, it's converting that into a clarinet. This little window here relates to the tracking for each instrument. So to get the best results, you kind of need to line up your target input with that zone, unless you're trying to create something sort of new and weird, which is also one of the great ways of using this. So you'll see, for example, if we select a flute, it has a different sort of tracking window, and comparably the violin and so on and so forth. And so if we choose a tuba, it's at lower pitch, so it's down here. We've also got controls to sort of pitch shift things, control how many harmonics we have, noise and output gain, and there's also some basic effects as well to sweeten things up with some reverb. So by way of comparison, if we wanted to kind of recreate this kind of effect, we could take something like a clarinet sampler instrument in the contact library, for example, and have it play a MIDI clip of that audio. So I've just extracted the MIDI from this piece of audio, and then I'm going to play that back using a clarinet sample instrument so we can compare the two. So let's listen to that now. So it sounds realistic because it's triggering samples of a clarinet, of course, but what it's not doing is using all the kind of expression and articulation that you get with a realistic performance. And that's because we haven't programmed any articulation. So we could go in and sort of, you know, go in on it and program which notes are going to be staccato or sustained notes or fortepiano and what have you. But this kind of this process, although it's not perfect, kind of captures that without us having to meticulously program the MIDI. So it's a bit of an upgrade on using MIDI. However, if you listen to this carefully, you will hear there's an almost like auto-tune style effect going on, which can sound a little bit unnatural. And you can kind of see it as well when it's like leaping around, trying to latch onto the right pitch. And it produces a few artifacts. So the way I found to kind of get around that, if you don't necessarily want that effect, is to use the best of both worlds. So we're going to take the MIDI from that clip and now run that playing a guitar in this case, which was what the original one was, but then being morphed into a clarinet. And it just kind of tidies up the signal to give us something that sounds a bit cleaner. So again, not completely perfect, but it kind of irons out some of those pitch tracking issues that you get with real audio. And also a lot of the time, real audio has perhaps some processing on it, some reverb or some delay, things like that, which will throw off the DDSP engine as well. So that's one way of using DDSP in live. Let's take a look now at another way you can use it. Hey guys, I hope you're enjoying the content. Just to let you know that we offer online courses in a range of creative subjects. So if you're interested in taking your skills and knowledge to the next level, check out the link below. So another way we can use DDSP as an effect is as a send. So I've put it here now on a send one. And what I'm gonna do now is take a vocal and use DDSP to add a harmony. So in order to do this, we need to be able to control the mix of that signal, and that's why we're using it as a send rather than directly on the channel itself. Let's listen to it how it is to start with. So now let's send some signal to send one. Wepa, 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 la vida es una fiesta si la vivo a tu lado. Wepa, 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 la vida es una fiesta si la vivo a tu lado. And so we can add in a clarinet. We could try a trumpet as well. Wepa, 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 la vida es una fiesta si la vivo a tu lado. Wepa, 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 la vida es una fiesta si la vivo a tu lado. There's also these vowels which work well for vocal harmonies. So let's try a fifth. Wepa, 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 la vida es una fiesta si la vivo a tu lado. Wepa, 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 la vida es una... And we can also play around with the tracking to get some different results. Wepa, 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 la vida es una fiesta si la vivo a tu lado. Wepa, 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 la vida es una fiesta si la vivo a tu lado. And so that can be a really cool and quite different effect that kind of tracks the dynamics and the input signal, but then produces a melodic layer to go along with it as well. Okay, so let's take a look now at using DDSP as a synth in its own right. So we can use DDSP as a synth in its own right, in which case we're not providing it with an input, we're simply choosing the sound that we want, and then we're going to be using it as an instrument. So I've just copied across the guitar MIDI part that we had from before. Let's see how it does using the clarinet preset. So it doesn't sound completely realistic, but it is actually quite a realistic representation of a clarinet. But really, for me, where this comes into its own is then being able to take these sounds and sort of really mangle them. So let's go for something like a tuba, for example. And we can play around with the tracking. Thank you. So we could actually automate the pitch tracking as well if we wanted to kind of record some of that movement in there. And so we can kind of really play around with the pitch and come up with some weird and new and wonderful sounds. Where this will really come into its own is if we can use it to train a new model on our own sounds. So for me, I'd love to be able to take some really techy neurofunk kind of bass and make an instrument out of that that I could then play. Unfortunately, that functionality doesn't appear to be working at the moment, but hopefully if this is still being developed, that will be something that's forthcoming in the future. So there's lots of different ways we could potentially use DDSP. And I think I would encourage you to go out and try and get creative to see what you can do with it. One thing that I found that's quite cool is to use it as a way to bring low end back into overly distorted sounds. So I like making drum and bass, and quite often you find when you're making sounds that they end up losing some of their low end because you're kind of driving the distortion quite hard. And in particular, recently I've been making sounds using AI to generate kind of neurofunk sounds, and that can end up with some great sounds, but they can sound sort of overly distorted sometimes. For example, here's one I made earlier. So by routing DDSP on ascend, we can then bring some of that back in by bringing the pitch tracking down and pitch shifting the signal down. So let's take a listen to that. And then by modulating the pitch tracking as well, we can also create some quite interesting sound design possibilities, kind of all sort of morphing, sort of growling type of texture. So that's DDSP-VST. It is in version 1 at the moment. Hopefully it will continue to be developed, but otherwise I think it's a really interesting addition to the AI landscape, particularly from a synthesis point of view, because it allows you to take any input and morph it using a neural network to create a realistic output. And of course you can then subvert that and use it to make weird and wonderful sounds that you might not otherwise be able to make in any other way. And it's also got those applications as an effects plugin as well. So if you enjoyed the video, hit that like and subscribe to get more great videos like this from us here at the DBS Institute. But that's it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.